I'm Tom Peters. I'm currently Chief of Orthopedic Surgery at Tuba City Regional Healthcare Corporation Hospital.
Dr. Steven Melichuk, I'm from Pennsylvania. I've been here for almost 4 years now.
I came from Puerto Rico in 2003.
And then I heard the news that I was going to transfer from the United States Air Force to United States Public Health Services, and I was going to be working at the Navajo Reservation, and I didn't have a clue what to expect.
My mother came with a newspaper and she said, "Hey, look at this. They're looking for nurses in a reservation." I'm like, "A reservation?"
Our facility is different in that when we have a plan, we can act on it. We can hire people within 6 weeks.
But the next day I pick up the phone, I called and I said, "Are you coming to the island to interview?" And sure enough, they were going. And 6 months later, I was here.
We've had a fourfold increase in our case volume in the implant service. We run an active trauma service.
Most of our doctors are emergency certified, so they are emergency medicine doctors.
The kind of healthcare we have is already coordinated in that we have all the pieces.
We have a corresponding group of podiatric limb salvage surgeons and a podiatric residency as part of the orthopedic department.
I'm a second year podiatry resident. When I'm done, I will be a podiatrist.
Another difference for the nursing staff that comes new is that they have come from other big hospitals and they don't expect to be the nurse and the trauma nurse because there's a trauma team. But here you are it. You're the nurse, you're the trauma nurse, you're the charge nurse, you have a lot of hats to wear.
So my wife and I take a trip to Tuba City, and we're driving and they say, "Wow, are we still in the United States? So this is another country." And we just kept driving until we got to the little town, and you can just see the different colors of the hills and the mountains and the landscape. I said, "Yeah, I think we can handle living here."
We have built the 3-story outpatient building. We've added a Native American program for spiritual healing.
Here you have all these, the code talkers. What a privilege, you know. I have taken care of them. And when you read their history and you know where they're coming from, the grandmas with their stories, I mean, it's a lot. It's a lot, and it's very fulfilling. Very fulfilling.
Really painfully image that I shoot will show up on this monitor over here. And whatever needs to be saved, whatever a surgeon is, you know, in an OR and they want a certain image saved, to save those images, hook it up to the Ethernet cable, and then send it off to our system.
We're currently embarking on a program of hiring a new, younger staff to bring in some fresh blood for our implant program.
I was on call one weekend, and I got to scrub in with Dr. Jensen. She's the general surgeon. She's actually from this community. I was just retracting for her, and she did this procedure with so much ease, and I was just like, I was so like, "Oh, this is awesome." I'm a resident on the reservation, in a reservation hospital. I'm assisting a Navajo surgeon that grew up here. This is wild. I would have never.
You know, we have seen a vast improvement in the emergency room since I've been here, just because of the talent that we've been able to, you know, to recruit from, you know, outside facilities, outside institutions and residencies.
Then the next day, I get a call from Dr. Lansing, who's the hand surgeon. She was on call. And I was retracting for her, and then I was sewing up, and I was like, this is just the greatest weekend for me to assist two female Navajo surgeons.
Everybody here, their families somewhere else. And now your coworkers are your family, your extended family. Your patients are the people you see in the post office, in the flea market on Friday, in Basha's at the line, you know? And all of a sudden you get this sense of community.
It seems to me like everybody's here for the same purpose. There is not necessarily a distinction that I'm a doctor and you're a nurse, or I'm a supervisor and you are a regular employee. Everybody's here for the same reason, for the same purpose, and you know, it's just like you are accepted as a part of a family. So that's a good feeling.
Once people get out here, they tend to stay for a little bit, because it's a very unique environment. It's a very nice place to work.
Two years after my contract was done, I stayed, and another year passed by, and then I met my husband in Tuba City. And he's a lab tech. He works here in the laboratory. He's from Kansas. What are the odds of that? Yeah.
I was on a high because that was my experience.